and welcome to my channel. Today I've got my first holiday season makeup tutorial of this year on my channel for you. Yeah. Obviously I went for glittery eyelids because there is no point in which I think there's too much glitter. I love glitter, I love shimmers, I love metallics, so here we are. This is really a look that you could actually do if you have plans for the holidays. Any plans at all, because it won't require you to get up at 5 in the morning and then spend 5 hours on your makeup. It's actually quite quick and easy to do, so let's get started. We're just gonna start off with the eye primer already done, because it's like the easiest step ever. You just apply it on the eyelid, obviously. So yeah, we're skipping immediately to the transition shade. I'm using quite a neutral shade, because I want to go for both silver and gold today. So, you know, warm and cold. And a neutral transition shade is not going to clash with either, which is kind of nice. The specific eyeshadows and every product really I use will be listed below the video as always. But, you know, as usual, you totally don't have to use the same products, because I'm going to use shades that are like, you know, in every single makeup brand's collection somewhere. So yeah, just use whatever you have and you'll be fine. Next up, just gonna darken up the crease with a dark brown shade. And this is also still quite a neutral shade. I'm putting it on a small brush so I can really, you know, keep it localized. And just slowly start building it up. And yeah, by the way, the entire month of December, just so you know, is going to be holiday themed on my channel. You can mostly tell from my background, really, because there's going to be things hanging there. Decoration. The looks themselves, of course, you can use them for any occasions, but still, yeah. Point being, though, I can imagine that some people this year are like, well, why would they even bother dressing up and doing fancy makeup for Christmas? We can't go anywhere anyway, and we can't be, you know, with all, like in most countries at least, you can't invite all your family and just have a big, big Christmas dinner like some people have each year. And I do get that feeling, but me personally, well, it's basically the same thing as, you know, I shave down under even though I'm single as heck. You know, I try to look good for me because it makes me feel good about myself. I like taking care of myself. And I just like making an effort because it makes me happy. So even though not a lot of people are actually going to see you, you know, it's still worth it, in my opinion at least, to dress up just because it makes you feel good about yourself. If it doesn't, then of course there is no point to it indeed. But as long as it makes you feel good to look good, then there's always a point to it and it's always worth the effort. So yeah, that's the reason why I'm just, you know, doing the holiday themed makeup tutorials and the fancy stuff anyways. Me personally, I gotta admit, me and my parents, we always celebrate just the three of us because we don't really have a lot of family, you know, that we actually hang out with, basically. Although normally we do in fact actually not stay at home, but go to a hotel instead. Just moving on to a brow bone highlight, matte one by the way. But yeah, this year we decided not to, because even though hotels are open right now and they're expected to stay open, we still don't want to take the risk, because it would just suck if we would make plans like that. And, you know, then they would not actually happen maybe at the last moment. And then we'd suddenly have to think of something else. Big fluffy blender, no extra product. Why is there a glitter on my eyebrow? Just ignore that. But anyway, so we decided to just keep it safe and just, you know, plan on just celebrating the holidays at home and just make food ourselves. We all like cooking, so yeah, that's basically because we know at least for sure that that way all our plans can just happen no matter what. So yeah, that's just, I don't know, like a lot more easy to look forward to, because we just know that we, you know, big disasters aside, can actually celebrate Christmas that way. Now it's time for the fun part, the sparkles. Yeah, just me personally, I'm just dampening a flat brush, very stiff eyeshadow brush, and just dumping it in a very yellow true gold eyeshadow shade, which sort of turns into a foil, as you can tell. But anyway, me personally, that was the point that I was trying to make. I always do actually get into the holiday vibes by, I don't know, messing around with colors like these. Christmas decorations and all, like even without, you know, being able to go Christmas shopping like usual, there's still a lot of ways to just get into the holiday vibes, I feel. Because you can, as usually, or at least in most countries, I mean, go shopping almost as usual. Just as usually with a shopping cart to keep distance and all, and so they know how many people are in the store. But especially if you go on like a Monday morning when it's like very, very quiet, then you can just go shopping. And like most people have Christmas decorations at home anyway, so you can also just decorate your home. And you can watch Christmas movies. Always nice, I'm a bit of a movie addict. Regular viewers probably know by now, I'm moving to silver by the way. But yeah, for example, one of my favorite Christmas movies is Love Actually. I watch it with my mom every year. I also really like The Nightmare Before Christmas, which I feel you can watch at Halloween and at Christmas. Because why not? The word Christmas is even in the name of the movie. Seriously. And also, I recently watched Kiss Kiss Bang Bang for the first time. Which actually, well, I watched it for the first time. Like, I saw someone talking about, by the way, I'm using a bronze shade now, on a fluffy blur brush just to blend out the outer corner. But anyway, I saw someone mention on a Tumblr blog about Robert Downey Jr. that he looks really hot in that movie, so of course I wanted to see it. And it happens to also take place around Christmas time, so you can also, in my opinion, at least treat that as a Christmas movie. So yeah, watching holiday movies is also a good idea, I feel, to get into the Christmas and the, or at least the holiday spirit, whatever holidays you celebrate. Oh, and holiday music, of course. Like, a lot of radio stations, like, especially online, they have, like, only Christmas songs. Just to define the cut crease a little bit more, I'm moving on to an eyeliner brush, also dampening that, and then going into the silver shade to use it as a bit of an eyeliner to outline the cut crease. But, yeah, and in terms of movies, one movie that's not really a Christmas movie, but I always watch on Christmas Eve, is Labyrinth. Regular viewers know my obsession with Labyrinth. But yeah, the first time I watched it ever was on Christmas Eve. And it sort of turned into a tradition for me personally. I know it originally came out in summer and it's totally not a holiday movie at all, but still. And I only allow myself to watch it on Christmas Eve because otherwise I would watch it all the time and I probably wouldn't get tired of it, but I start to know it too well, you know, like... Just like with really nice ice cream, you know, you don't want to eat it too often because you'll get used to it. Yeah, that's basically my logic with it. Although I do listen to the soundtrack all year long. Because that's different. Put you up a little bit closer because we're going to do the eyeliner now and I'm going to use a gel liner actually. Because I want to do a bit of a smudgy liner, I think. And that's obviously easier with a gel liner than with a liquid. Easy, I say, but I barely ever do gel liner, so... This really isn't easy to me at all. It's a process. But yeah, basically I'm just gonna do a normal liner first, I think, and then move on to the smudging part. Okay, while I try to get a courage to do the other eye that way, I'm going to very carefully use this completely destroyed black eyeshadow that I've been using for ages. It's all over my fingers now. I'm gonna have to clean that before I get it all over my face. Actually, it doesn't matter. I still need to do my foundation anyway. But yeah, I'm just gonna carefully, very carefully use that to smudge the liner a little bit. It's all over the brush too. Okay, so that's it. Then it's just time to go around the bottom side, only the bottom side, with a little bit of makeup remover on an angled brush. Try to clean it up, then do the face base, which I'm going to do quickly off camera, and then continue on the eyes. Okay, face is on. I kept it quite almost natural-ish. I did do a little bit of contour, but only a little, and I also used foundation instead of a BB cream, because I really do want my face to be matte. Especially in comparison with all the glitter on my eyelids. I used a red blush very carefully because I also want to do a red lipstick. And I used a very shimmery highlight. It's by Catrice. The name faded off the packaging, but I'll look it up and put it below the video. No idea if they still sell it, actually, but it's very cheap, very shimmery, almost glittery, really. And I feel like it complements the eye look really well. Anyway, that means that we can actually continue on the under eye area. So I'm just using the stump brush that I just smudged with. I pronounced that really weird. Anyway, but I'm gonna put that below the brown eyeshadow, below the... Let me start that sentence again. I'm going to grab the brown eyeshadow, the dark brown eyeshadow, on the short stump brush that I used for blending and smudging earlier. And put that below my eye, starting from the wing and then carefully blending it inwards. If there's still some black eyeshadow in the brush, that's actually fine. It's just going to help make it a little bit darker even. Then, because I'm so pale, if you're not this pale, then you can use only the taupe shade. But I'm going to grab the taupe shade I used in the beginning and the matte brow bone highlight. Mix them on the brush, a blending brush. And then use that to blend. I feel like for my skin tone, if I just use the taupe shade, I'm just going to make a huge big shadow below my eye. Which is not what I'm going for today. And then for the inner corner highlight, I'm basically just going to make sure that the silver shades... You know, is also blended downwards and not just sitting on top, ending abruptly. Then to really get the intensity in there, I'm going to use a black eye pencil and I'm carefully putting it on my waterline. Now really, I am careful because my old contact lenses never did get a stain out of them. Anyway, and I'm also pulling it in my inner corner because I really want this to go all around my eye. And then eyelashes. I don't want to hide all the glitter that I just applied, so I'm going to go for quite a natural-ish pair, I think. Either way, this is the before. And here is the after. Just gonna apply some mascara and then the eyes are done. Okay, then only the final step, the very final step, a festive red lipstick, and then we're completely done. Here we have the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you don't want to miss anything of my holiday tutorials, please subscribe to my channel. Other than that, as always, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day and I hope to see you next time. Bye!